Well, good morning, fish people. I'm Alan Norris from FishOn TV. It is Friday, the 8th of March, and I've just arrived here at Langold Lakes. It's the Qualifier tent. It's my last chance saloon. Got all my gear ready. We're all queuing up waiting for the draw, which is in a minute. So I'll get there, I'll video the draw, we'll see where we get drawn. Apparently they've put some new carp in here. But what I will say is I've been looking for a ticket, and Mark Cooper, I put a message on there. Mark Cooper's sent me a message saying you can have my ticket, and literally meant it, I could have it. Wow, I didn't know what to say. So big thank you, big shout out to Mark Cooper. Thanks very much, pal. He said he couldn't make it. He didn't realise it were on a Friday. So I will try my damnedest. I think that's a little bit of an omen. Let's hope. We'll see how we get on there. There's been a thousand pound of carps being put in recently. My experience is when new fish goes in, they tend not to feed straight away, but you just never know with fishing, do you? Apparently, I've not checked it yet. Apparently the water's a bit clearer. So hopefully there should be some better fish, and I'm going to approach it a little bit different. I'm going to be a bit more patient. I'm going to go for the skimmers. I'm not going to target the tiny little ones. We'll see. We'll see what happens. I'm hoping for a few better fish today. So we'll see you guys at the draw. Let's see how we get on. I think there's three qualifiers go through today. You have to win your zone of 10. So there we are. Let's see how we get on. See where we get drawn. Not particularly bothered where I get drawn, because I don't know what the... I've never seen anywhere that's been like, wow, that's the peg. It's just a case of, it's been that murky as the water, chocolatey. It's just been a case of, if somebody's dropped on and a fish has been grubbing about, they've caught one. And that's how it's been. But hopefully today it will be a little bit better. Apparently there were a few skimmers caught yesterday. Let's see how we get on, eh? Right, see you guys at the draw.
Danny boy.
No, you'll take that every day of the week.
Oh, that's 3 days.
Yeah, you're getting close.
Yeah, it's expensive, isn't it? Yeah.
That's on them.
Steve's going to nick your good peg now. All right, that's Steve.
I took the middle one.
Peg two.
Peg two?
Yeah.
Right, well here I am, peg two. I'm already baited up and chucked in. It is definitely the same peg. I've clipped up to 44 metres long and I've done 22 metres short. So, slightly different lines to what I've had before. On the shorter areas, I'm not going short down here for these smaller fish. I am going for a different tactic today. I'm going to sit it out and see if we can get some better skimmers, I think. Rather than being in and out every 5 minutes, I'm just going to give it 15 minute casts and have a look. And you just never know, we'll see what
things turn up. I've put a few micros out there with some chopworm and caster on the long line. And I've put chopworm and caster, dead reds and pinkies on my short line. I've done four, well, I've not got the feeds on my rod, four medium feederfuls. It's not a lot. I've sieved the ground bait, so the particles that are there are what I've added. So I'm going to leave that for a good, I'm going to give it a good hour and a half, I think, before I actually have a look on it. I might give it 2 hours, I don't know yet. We'll see what happens on this longer line. I've actually gone out on method to start with, just to have a look. I've got the F1 Sweet micros, bright yellow, very, very sweet tasting, smelling, should I say. That's for my wafters, just to check that they're sitting as they should. Got ground bait there, as you can see, a few micros. So I've got casters, pinkies, live maggots, dead reds, a few wafters. Dead simple. So my marker is where the diving board is over here, which is 44 metres. And then slightly so down there, you can see the hut. That's my line for my short line, so it's just slightly out of the way. I will be reeling fishing down there, keep that quiet. And let's hope some fish turn up. Apparently they had a few skimmers yesterday. I've not seen anybody catch fish yet. It's easterly wind. Now, I know some of you say, excuses are coming. They're not excuses. For some reason, a westerly, southwesterly wind always produces more fish than an easterly wind. Just a fact, it's just something I've noticed. So that's why I start writing stuff down, just to see what, just to compare different days with different winds and pressures and stuff. And there is definitely a pattern, so call it an excuse if you want, but I think it's going to be quite tough today. There's anglers on every peg just about. They reckon, because of the new fish they've put in and the water being slightly clear, as you can see, I can just see my net, it's still got some colour, with the water being a bit clearer, they are predicting, because the weights that have been qualifying have been like 2 pound and stuff, they're predicting between 6 and 15 to win your zone. So that's your target. And we'll see how we get on, eh? It's cold as well. So no excuses, but the easterly wind is a bloody cold one today. But I don't mind this bit of a breeze. It's definitely breaming weather. Let's just hope they get their heads down at some point, eh? See you guys during the match. 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, maybe 20 minutes on first cast. And 6 minutes in on the method. There's a gentle pull round, but I know it's enough for a bite and it feels like a bream. Steady. Nice start. And that method is sat exactly how I wanted it to be. Bait still in the feeder. And he's got to be 4 pound, I would have thought. Nice fish. That'll do. And as you can see, the pellets are still in the feeder. Three and a half to 4 pound, I reckon he's got to be. Good start for Nosh. All the pellets out. Well, I just test that wafter, make sure it's still sat okay. Yep. So happy with that. And I think that's going to be my plan today. Be a little bit more patient. Just make sure that waft has sat properly. The guy to my right's had a small skimmer. A little bit of spray. Oh, we'll get back out there. Come on, duck, move out of the way. Getting up a bit, that moved a little bit more, but it's not far away from where I was. There we go, lovely start. I put 4 on clicker and let's just hope we get a couple more, it'd be nice. Get in. Well, we're about 2 hours in. I thought I had a bite about half an hour ago. It must have been a big liner. It certainly looked like a bite, and this was less of a bite. Still on the method. It's like another bream. It doesn't feel as big as the last one. It's definitely a bream. Apparently it's 2 or 3 pound. Oh, a bit of a scrap. Now there's 2 or 3 pound to my right. So there's a few fish coming out. Stays on. Bit of skimmer, I think this. He's got to be, I don't know, he might be 2 pound maybe, so I'm happy with that. There we go, another one. And I was just about to go and try some red worms. I've put another feeder full. Take that wafter off, that's not quite sat right. I've put another feeder full of bait on that shorter line. Some chop worm and casters and things. And we'll give this another go. Just see how that sits. There's a bit of weed out there somewhere, which I never noticed when I was plumbing it up. But I'm quite happy about it. There's not a lot, but there's a bit, so I'm happy about that, because bream definitely like hanging about places like that. So just now and again, I just get a little bit on my hook. Make sure that's sat the right way. We've got to give it another go. Get back out there and see if we can get another one. The sun's come out. That's not great for bream, but it's all right for us because it is rather cold. That is banging the same spot. Nice one. We like that, don't we? We like it when it's in the same spot. Feeder full at 22 metres. That bite came after 12 minutes. And the bigger bream came after just after 6. and the big liner, it did half look like a bite. One, two, there's just nothing there. And that came after six as well, but like I say, I'm leaving it up to 15 minutes, being a bit patient, and hopefully that might pay off. So I'm going to put two down. So I've got about six, or just short of six. It's difficult to tell what they weigh. Like I said, the first one might have been 3.5 pound. It might have been four, I don't know. That might have been just short of two, might have been two. So I certainly think we've got five. I think it's a bit more, five and a bit, or maybe even six if I'm lucky. All set. What I am hoping for is, with being on the method, that I get a proper pull round, and it's one of those carp they put in. One of those around about 8 pound would be nice. Nothing like being greedy, is there? So this is definitely the best I've done here at Langold. A little change of tactics, purely and simply because of the colour of the water. I always thought there would be a bit more chance to catch one or two. Well, what are we on? It's nearly 12:10. We're fishing wild three, so it'd be nice. I've not touched that line down there. It would be nice to get a couple of decent fish from there. That would be perfect end if we could get a couple of those 3 pounders. That'd be absolutely wonderful. Well, anything really, absolutely anything can do. Right, hopefully we shall see. It's not action filled. It definitely feels like a day of patience. Not overfed it. Let's just hope those tactics work, eh? Right, hopefully see you on the next one. Well, I've had four indications. Three of them have been on the 6 minute 30 mark, and one at 12. So I was just about to pour a cup of coffee and it went straight around, a proper bite. Just gonna be gentle. This is massive, this, to land this, I think, today. Snagged on something. Yeah, we snagged on something there. Concentrating on this one. Gotta really concentrate, make sure we get it in. Slightly bigger than the last one, so certainly a couple of pounds or so. Right in the middle of the bottom of the lip. Bottom lip, should I say. There we go.
Get in. Get in, you beauty.
Come on, the breams. So that weed, I'm not sure that it's as I'm coming in. Let's have a look at that wafter. All looks good. Oh, no point going on the traditional just yet. If it's going round on the method, absolutely no point. Doesn't always work, but it's working today. I'll do a noshki on the bream. sat. Redo that. Like it to sit bang in the middle on the dinner plate. There we go. Must have just moved when I was squashing everything on. Just move slightly right, so we'll give it the 7 minutes. And if there's no good, we'll recast it. It's not far off the mark. Just the last, say it's probably a yard or so. But it's not a bad thing, that, because when I'm fishing for bream, anyway, I would try not down the same hole every time, but a little bit left, a little bit right, a little bit short, a little bit longer. It's just drifted, so we'll just give that a little bit. Give it 6 or 7 minutes. And give it the bite time time, and just see if we can. And then we'll have another recast and see if we can get another one. But yes. Got about 8 pound. They said 6 to 15 pound as your target, so I'd like to go the top end if possible. It only takes somebody to catch a big gap and they're in. So we've just got to keep going. Alright, I'll say it again. Hopefully, guys, we'll see you on the next one. Gone out with the traditional red worms on. It's a little skimmer or something, this. I can't believe it. Green little thing. Three red worms. Capped off with a red maggot. You can get a little settled. How greedy is that? Thought it wouldn't be with bite. With the bite, I thought it wouldn't be a lot bigger than that. We'll get these red worms on and we'll give it another cast out. Let's try that short line. Anytime now. There's an hour and a half left. I've had 4 casts out there actually, because I had a couple of bites. With a small skimmer. I'm going to leave that now. I'm going to have about 3/4 of an hour, half an hour to 40 minutes on this short line. So now we'll see. If I'm not getting any indications whatsoever, I may go out a little bit earlier, but I just feel like I need to rest that. There's some bait out there. Let it settle. And then I'll go back out and I'll sit up. I think I'll sit on a method and see it match out on method if there's nothing on this short line. Nobody's catching anything around me. I think I've seen the odd skimmer coming out. And I think it's winning the match, I think. But that's what the word is on the bank. Things have just dried up, but it is that time. It's that hour, sort of 12:30 or 2 o'clock-ish. Is a strange, it's a funny, it's like the witching hour. I've just gone on that. We're 4 minutes in, I've not had any indications whatsoever. It's the first time I've actually had a look on that line. So I didn't see any point when nobody were catching anything and I were getting the odd bite along, so we'll just rest that out there. If I've not had anything, so to buy. 2 o'clock, 2:10. probably go back out there, but I definitely feel like I need to just rest it. No line in it, no disturbers. Let them settle over that bit of bait. We'll have a look a bit later on, see if we can nick another one or two. But my only fear is someone catching a carp. And my best chance of catching a carp, I think, is probably on the method, so that's probably what I'll end up doing. So, little update for you. Sounds like I'm doing okay. Let's just keep his fingers crossed that it's going to be good enough. But like I say, I would like a few more fish to top up what I've got. And the wind's changed. It's coming at me a little bit more now. And it's bloody cold. Bloody hell. Let me get my hand warmer on. So there you go. Hopefully. See you on the next one, eh?
Well, we're all weighed in. And it's starting to change a bit on there for sure. I've also mentioned during that match a carp could easily wipe out those bream that I caught. Well, you saw the match. You saw what I was doing. I was going to be patient, sit on a method, and I've probably spent most of the match on the method, and I've had a few nice bream. I went on the short line with 2 hours to go, just short of 2 hours to go. Bumped a couple of skimmers. There were a snag halfway back that I bumped a couple off. You know, and you think that could just cost me that. But I've had a few indications, but really quick jabs. Not been able to really hook any more. Back out on the method, never had another bite. Left and right of me, nobody seemed to be catching any silvers, short anywhere. Just not seen many fish come out at all. But apparently on the other side, where you can chuck to the point of an island, what's his name? Kev Chalk has had 3 carp for £36, and 2 of them weighed 31. So he's won the match. So well done, Kev. You are Qualifier 10's mightiest fisherman. Well done, son. And Glenn Lawrence has hooked into 6 bream. So he's qualified as Kev. And 6 bream for about £18 is Glenn Lawrence. He's also qualified for the final in the other section. Neither of those two guys are in my section. And you have to win your section of 10. And on the scales, leading the way was 7 pounds, 7 ounces. I'm sorry, I can't remember your name. And the winner of our section with 7 pounds, 9 ounces, just 2 ounces in it, is yours truly. Get in. Oh, straight to the final for Nosh. So there we go, those bream, that little skimmer I caught, long on 3 worms, and 3 red worms and a pinky, I think it was, or a maggot, has just edged me in front of the other guy. So very close indeed. All our banks struggled. A lot of people have struggled, but there's been pockets. And the guy that caught the 3 carp, Kev there, he fished the last match fishing for carp, never had a bite, but he's had 3 this time. He's lost one as well, and he's 30-odd pounds. So apparently it's peg 36 and 37 that can chuck to the island. It's about 80 metres or so, which has got me thinking. I didn't realise you could chuck that far on here. That's apparently it's those 2 pegs you can. So that's got me thinking I ought to bring my 13-foot rod in case I draw that area. You just never know, dear. So just something to bear in mind for me. But yes, absolutely over the moon into the final. I think it's, I can't remember how much they said they were fishing. Was it 10 grand, I think? Or it's a decent amount. I don't know whether the prize pot's 10 grand or whether you're fishing for 10 grand. And that is on Good Friday at the end of March. So you will be joining me there in the Guru Cup final. Over the moon is an understatement. I'm absolutely chuffed to bits. So I've come third in the whole match, which gives you an indication that, you know, there's not been a lot of fish, weights of fish caught anywhere else really. So third in the match with that. So a nice little bonus for Nosh again. A few squidlies. That's three outings and three paydays for me. Woohoo, getting better. So what have I got next? You see, my final last chance saloon for the golden rod. It's at Lindome Lakes. It's over Benny's, Loco and Bonsai, I think. So I'll be there tomorrow. I will be taking the cameras for that one. It's my last chance there. There are more than a couple of pegs that you can draw that will give you a chance there. It's just a case of where the fish want to be. And just let's hope you get your tactics right and you end up winning your zone of 20 there tomorrow. So the cameras will be there and we'll see how we get on there tomorrow. So I hope you've enjoyed that. It's been a day of patience. The method was the best for me today. I've had bites on traditional, but it seems to be a lot of those small fish. I think it's worth sitting it out for a while you've baited areas up and hope that you can drop on some skimmers later. So I think the fishing will be a lot better, hopefully, in the final. And I'm really looking forward to it. So we'll definitely be taking the cameras for the final. So I hope you've enjoyed the video, folks. Don't forget, it is absolutely free to subscribe to this channel. If you click that notification bell, you will get all our videos as we upload them. And a thumbs up, boom, would be very, very nice. So it's definitely a pint tonight for Nosh. I'd like to say Chinese, but I like a ruby instead. Might have a ruby. Get in. Oh well, first big final. Well, I've been in a couple of finals, but this is quite a big one as far as money goes. So yeah, there we go. Over and out. Don't forget, folks, always fish on. And we shall see you on the banks at Lindome Lakes. Toodaloo.